Just keep trying. Richard, on my side, it's saying unable to join on the Project Angel Food side. Your Instagram will let me put you in, but okay. For some reason it won't. Okay, here we go. Perfect. All right. Excellent. Richard, I'm connecting with you now. There you are.
Hi, Kipton. How are you?
I'm really well. How are you? Oh my God, like there's so many people doing these lives now that Instagram is overloaded. I had to upgrade my Wi-Fi yesterday just to make sure it wasn't my side.
But sending you love, Kipton.
Oh my God. Look, I wore the blue to match.
Good. Thank you.
It's so amazing to see you, and I'm excited to bring everybody on the feed to meet Richard Ayub, who's the executive director of Project Angel Food here in Los Angeles. I mean, he's done incredible work. He's been doing incredible work for many, many years. I mean, since 1989, there's been, sorry, my light went off there. There's been so much that you've done to deliver healthy meals to people affected by serious illness and, you know, bringing joy and comfort to people every single day. So I know we're gonna do this virtual art auction today and talk about that a little bit. But first of all, catch us up on what you've been doing. How are you guys doing? How are the volunteers doing? And share that with us.
Project Angel Food, as Kipton said, has been around for 30 years. And we serve meals, medically tailored meals, to people with all forms of cancer, heart disease, lung disease, diabetes, kidney failure, HIV. And every meal is tailored to their medical needs. Every meal adheres to their nutritional guidelines. And so now that COVID-19 is going on, our client population is the population most prone to contract the coronavirus. They're over the age of 60, they have heart disease, lung disease, diabetes. These are the people who have compromised immune systems. And so those are the ones that we take the meals to, so they don't have to try and go to grocery stores and push their way through, because they're the ones who should definitely stay at home. And so these meals are frozen, they're packed with all of the nutrients, flavor, and aroma, and no preservatives.
Amazing. And how long has the organization been around?
We've been around for 30 years. We just celebrated 30 years. And, you know, we were born in response to a pandemic, the AIDS crisis. Marianne Williamson wanted to make sure people dying of AIDS got nutrition. And on top of it, they also received love. And so now, 30 years later, what's happening is we have another pandemic. And we're sending meals and love to people.
Yeah.
And we really feel like we were born for this moment.
Amazing. Well, I mean, you're doing beautiful work. What are some of the biggest challenges that you're facing right now during COVID?
The biggest challenge we're facing is we get 50 to 70 phone calls a day from people in need, people who need food, people who need our services. And so I have committed to serving another 400 people within this month.
Wow.
And that's going to mean that we will be serving 2,000 people at Project Angel Food.
It's incredible.
To prepare and deliver that kind of meal constantly is really phenomenal. And we want to make sure that every single client continues to get their meals uninterrupted.
Mm-hmm. So tell us some stories. So some of the people that you've been serving on a daily basis for a long time. Can you tell us a couple stories that come to mind?
Absolutely. So one story that I can tell you is the other day I was in our lobby to pick up my mail, and there was this gentleman standing there, and he was waiting for his meals. Mm-hmm. He was one of those people who has some mobility and can come in and pick up meals. He actually mm-hmm. lives in the neighborhood. And he said, "Are you Richard?" I said, "Yes, I am." He goes, "Would you mind if I hug you?"
Oh.
And I said, "No." And he hugged me, and he held on to me, and he didn't say any words, but you felt what he was feeling. Oh, and it was Richard. Immense gratitude, respect, and love for what we do. That's the kind of feedback I'm lucky that I get for doing this work.
Yeah. Well, they're depending on you not only to eat and to live, but the human connection that you're providing through the work of Project Angel Food is amazing. And the volunteers that you have, they're incredible too. Talk about that a little bit. Like, now you're not able to accept volunteers temporarily, I think because of COVID, but can you share a little bit about the volunteer network that you have in the kitchen and prepping the meals every day?
From day one, Project Angel Food has been a volunteer-led organization. When we started in 1989, we were in a church at the corner of Fountain and Fairfax in this makeshift kitchen, and it was 100% volunteers. Volunteers cooked, volunteers delivered, and we've always kept that community spirit until just a couple of weeks ago. For the first time in 30 years, we've suspended our volunteers in the kitchen because there's such an outpouring of love for Project Angel Food in Los Angeles County, mm-hmm. that when we said 22 corporate volunteer groups canceled within 48 hours, we had 300 phone calls from people saying, "I'll volunteer." And so we had 200 volunteers come through our doors in one single week. And our board of directors and I met, and we decided we are gonna suspend volunteerism for the first time in 30 years, and we're gonna hire some out-of-work chefs so we minimize the potential of spreading this virus.
Amazing, wow, Richard. I mean, it's really moving. I mean, I have really enjoyed getting to know you since I moved to Los Angeles. And I mean, it's incredible the amount of respect that Project Angel Food has and the amount of love that the organization receives from everyone here. Talk about like the piece of art behind you. I know the purpose of our call, one was to raise awareness for Project Angel Food today, but also to raise funds because your fundraising campaign has obviously been slowed down a little bit because of the epidemic that we're facing right now. And we want to do what we can to kind of sell some of these pieces of art that have been generously
donated. Let's sell them, Kipton.
Let's sell them. We have a lot of people on here today. And talk about the neon piece behind you.
Oh my God, it's amazing. And I want to bring in Laura Watts, part of our team. And
hi, Laura.
You know Laura.
Of course.
Laura, say hi to Kipton.
Hi, Kipton.
Hi, Laura.
Hi.
Well, we're
super fortunate to have this long-standing partnership with Alexandra Grant and Grant Love Project, which is an initiative that she started in 2008 as a way to use her artwork to give back to the Los Angeles community. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so this Love Neon is... it's available for $20,000, and it's one of three that she donated to us. And so this is a very desirable piece, and we have this one left for one lucky buyer.
And I want to interject, Alexandra is the most, we're trying to keep 6 feet away, so we're maneuvering our way. Alexandra is the most generous, loving individual. We just think she's incredible. And the other two buyers who have this posted it or installed it outdoors. It's a beautiful outdoor piece. And of course, it can be indoor as well. But This is the last one. It's in our second floor lobby. I would hate to give it up, but if we got $20,000 to take people off our waiting list and feed more people, we'll rip it off.
So, Richard, give us an idea of what, give us an idea of what $20,000, how many meals would that feed?
$20,000 will pay for 4,000 meals for people living with critical illness in Los Angeles.
And how many days would that last you, 4,000 meals?
Well, 365 meals last you a year. So okay. Ask you how many,
okay.
How many years, 10 years?
Okay, awesome. and talk about the prints that are underneath. So those are more affordable prints, everybody. So she did those in four different colors.
Yes, these prints are the beginning of a collaboration between Alexander Grant and Oscar De La Renta that is going to benefit Project Angel Food. So these four love prints, again, it's this, you know, her signature Grant love symbol, is made in these four colorways inspired by this spring summer 2020 collection from Oscar De La Renta. And each of these are available for $150, and you can go onto our website and link to her site to purchase these. And or you can just go directly to grantlove.com, and 100% of the proceeds of these prints are being donated to Project Angel Food. In fact, 100% of the proceeds of the sales of all of these artworks today are going to help to feed people who are very vulnerable right now because of COVID.
Yeah,
and if you can also, I wanted to mention, get this frame.
Framed, yeah.
And that's $300, this frame.
Yeah.
And this is the one that I bought myself. I like it. It's shimmering blue on blue.
Like your eyes.
Kind of like my eyes.
You're matchy.
Sorry, like Paul, I had to jump in. I had a little...
We have the whole team there. I love it. So those are limited edition prints, everybody. They're editions of 100. And like Richard and Laura said, they're $150 each for the prints. If you want them framed, they're $300. The neon piece, which is one of her signature pieces there behind you, measures. Let's get the measurements for people that are looking for a wall. It's 33 inches tall by 48 inches wide. And that's $20,000.
And then this, each of these are numbered and signed, which is really great.
Perfect.
And this is 14 by 11.
Okay. Those are beautiful. I love the colors. I love the message. And she did that. She was really inspired by what Project Angel Food is doing. What's the next piece of art we can see?
Okay, shall we show this one?
Oh, yes. We have one sold. We have something sold. The blueprint is sold. Okay.
The blueprint, good.
Yay. Oh. All right. Thank you, John Guile.
Wonderful. His virtual auction doing well. Richard, it was your eyes.
Off to a good start.
And that's $150 is 2 weeks of meals for our new client.
It is. Yes.
So
fantastic.
Thank you. You just
it's two weeks of meals
for our new client.
And then the magic of love in your home, which is really important and special right now. I bought one for myself. I bought the one in the back that is the sort of coral color, which is pretty. And Laura, pick that one up and show how that one shines too.
Put it in the light.
It's a silver metallic, which is really pretty.
Yeah.
You don't get to see it until you get the light in it.
That's beautiful.
It's a foil print on coral cardstock.
And then the gold one here is really beautiful because it shows kind of a metallic, it's gorgeous. It's really pretty.
Oh,
what's
yeah,
great
you can see the
about
gold.
This one here
nice.
Is these were the colors of Austin High School. When I went to high school, like in the early 90s, and graduated with honors.
Of course you did.
Of course you did, Richard.
Honor. But that's all that aside. But these were the Panthers, the Austin High Panthers.
Amazing.
This reminds me of our senior class.
And don't we think Oscar De La Renta's creative team thought that too?
That's
sure
they
did. And the pink one over here, which is really pretty because it's also, if you lift that up, Richard, show how that's
what's, out. Yeah, can you put that up to the light?
It's yes, it's like a rose gold with pink. It's beautiful.
Perfect.
Really pretty.
That's really nice. $150. $150 would feed, what, 2 weeks of meals, right, Laura?
Yes, for a brand new client.
Okay, that's really great. Okay.
And this one, Laura, you want to talk about this? This, I'm going to go ahead and say that he has a famous husband. He's an accomplished artist on his own. But
can I say who his husband is?
He wants to know if he can say who the husband is.
Yes, Ricky Martin.
Ricky Martin's husband is an incredible artist. He is a well-known artist on his own without being married to Ricky, but that piece is 27 by 22 inches by Juan Yosef. The retail value on that piece is $7,000, and there's a reserve of $5,500 on that piece. So he generously donated that to Project Angel Food as well. So really accomplished artist and beautiful technique that he used. It's oil on linen and aluminum.
And will you tell the gallery that?
Oh, yeah. I think one of my favorite things about Juan's work is this juxtaposition of traditional art materials and lowbrow construction, hardware store type materials. And so you see that juxtaposition with the fine linen canvas and the oil painting gesso on the surface, and then the aluminum frame exposed. So you have this object that, and that's the title of the work, Object, actually, the object, that really blurs the boundaries between painting and sculpture. So it's this really unique piece. And he was born in Syria and lives and works here in Los Angeles. All of our artists here that we're featuring today are local artists that generously have supported us. Juan works with a gallery here in LA that is hugely supportive of Project Angel Food, Praz de la Balade.
Dear friends of ours.
Yes. So he's with a great gallery here in LA. And
I went to the opening reception for his art show, his exhibit there, and he was there. He was lovely. I chatted with him. He was really very interested in Project Angel Food. And at that moment, he said, I want to donate a work of art to you.
That's very sweet.
He's really sensational and lovely. He's Syrian. I'm Lebanese. We have a connection.
You have a connection.
Except the connection's not Ricky Martin, I think.
Oh, well. I've seen Ricky before.
Yeah.
So, twice. Once with a lot of 12-year-old screaming girls, and then once with the charity group. But that's just an aside.
All right, what's next?
I love this print. This is this sort of, it's a sort of nostalgic, sort of whimsical thing. It reminds me of the Jungle Book a little bit, of like this sort of, shirtless boy engaging with nature. And that's very much what Enrique Martinez Pelea's work is often about. It's about how we as human beings live in and interact with our environment. And this is a print, actually, an edition of 50. And we have not just this one here that's framed, but we have a few more available as well. This is available for $5,000. And Enrique is represented by LA Louvre Gallery, which is based out in Venice. And yep, they've been longtime supporters of us in the past as well.
Enrique has also... And he's lovely. I met him as well. And he's from Cuba. He's irresistible. He's an incredible artist and just in person has a very strong presence. And this printing process, I don't know if you can explain it, Laura, but you look at it and it looks like it was actually painted. It's different layers of ink on it. And what is that process?
It's a lithograph on Coventry rag paper is the material. And so, I actually am not super familiar with the reconstruction of this particular piece. But yes, you can see that it doesn't look like a print. You get
Can you get the camera really close to it?
Yeah, we're going to get up in there.
Yeah, because it's the rag paper, so it's a little thicker paper.
Yeah, show that corner right there.
Yeah. Yeah, now you can see it better. That's beautiful. Wow, it's nice.
It's really beautiful. And this piece sits in our lobby here on Vine Street at Project Angel Food. And this is, like Laura said, 100% of the sales of all of these go towards Project Angel Food.
So if you receive $5,000, for example, for that piece, how many meals would that be translating?
That's 1,000 meals.
Okay.
Look at this as feeding 1,000 people.
Wow, that's incredible, Richard. Okay. All right. Somebody wants to buy the love, the pink love piece. Can you go back to that one and hold that one up to the camera again?
Pink love, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Rose gold is beautiful.
And just the best way to purchase these prints is at grantlove.com. So those amazing viewers, thank you for watching, who are going to help us feed clients for 2 weeks with the purchase of each of these. Please go to grantlove.com to purchase these.
You'll be thrilled with them. They're beautiful.
And they'll be sent to you, the whole shebang. Show them this last piece we have.
Okay. Oh, this is one of my favorites, and this is this piece by Leah Halloran, who's was born in Chicago, but lives and works here in Los Angeles. And she's represented by Jesus de Luis. Luis de Jesus in Culver City. And so this piece, which was made in 2013, was made by the artist strapped a light to her body and then skateboarded through the LA riverbed and photographed herself doing that with a very slow time-lapse exposure. So she disappears from the photo.
Oh, amazing.
You get just this amazing neon streak of light, which I think actually works so well.
Can you get closer to that, the cameraman? Oh, that's cool. That's very cool.
So, Kipton, just so you know, this piece sits in my office.
Uh-huh.
I would hate to give it up, but we will for the right price.
So that would feed, what, about 600?
This is
3,500.
Well, it's 3,500, but it would feed about, what, 600 people?
700 people.
700 people. Okay. Trying to do the math. That's incredible. I love that. Okay, so that's an edition one of four. Again, that was donated by Leah Halloran, called Passage LA, done in 2013.
Right, absolutely.
Okay. So what else? Anything else you want to show us? On the art?
Oh, okay, on the art.
Yeah, or can we go in the kitchen? Can we do a tour?
We can go in the kitchen. I need to get a baseball cap.
Okay. Yeah. I want to show everybody their incredible facility and how they're prepping these meals.
Yeah, let's go into the kitchen.
Can I just say one more thing? I wanted to thank you, Kipton, for doing this feature, and I just wanted to give a big shout out to the Los Angeles arts community in general, which has been supporting Project Angel Food and our Angel Art Auctions for about almost as long as we've been open, since 1989. So we're just very grateful to live in a community
absolutely.
With a rich arts culture and with artists and galleries that are really so generous and so invested in making sure that we can realize our mission.
You know, that's a really good point, Laura. Thank you for pointing that out. The artist community here in Los Angeles really is amazing, and how everybody is pulled together has been really inspirational. I mean, I lived in New York for 17 years, and I've been here for 2 years, and I really feel this energy here, and especially right now and during what we're going through, it's been really beautiful. So,
well, and you're included in that arts community now. You know, we're so grateful to you for shining the light on the work that we have.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
My pleasure. Whatever I can do. I mean, I love you guys.
You.
I love
we
arts.
Love your workouts.
What? More workouts? Okay. For you, Richard.
Thank you.
Take us to the kitchen.
Okay. We're going to put on our masks.
Okay.
Show them this, Anne Marie. You see that? That's our motto: for life, for love, for as long as it takes.
That's in the in the stairwell.
Yes.
Your Wi-Fi is a little tricky there.
Surviving client was with us for 27 years. He passed away a couple of years ago, and he needed us for every one of those 27 years. So we live and breathe that motto. As long as it takes, we're going to be there for you.
That's beautiful, Richard. Thank you.
You're welcome.
They're going in the stairwell, everybody, down to the kitchen right now. So the Wi-Fi is a little spotty in the stairwell, but I'm excited for you guys to see the kitchen. It's quite an amazing facility that they have there.
Here we go. We have this quote from Marianne Williamson: "In every community, there's work to be done, and every heart there's power to do it." Marianne is our founder.
We love Marianne.
Want to make sure that her vision, her energy is felt here.
That's amazing. Thank you, Richard, for bringing that up.
Loves.
I had the opportunity to go with Richard last year. I went on a tour and went in the kitchen and was just blown away at how many meals that you produce. I mean, last year I know you celebrated 12 million meals that you delivered, right? How many million meals are you up to now? Are you close to 13 million?
We're about to hit 13 million.
It's incredible.
We keep on going. So this kitchen usually has about 25 to 30 people, but social distancing, suspending volunteers, and hiring staff, we have fewer people. Still, no one has missed a meal. The service continues uninterrupted.
Amazing.
Look at this fresh fruit. We get some donations from Food Forward and also from the Wisconsin. And so our client, every client gets 10 pieces of fruit every single week. And so they get fresh fruit. This is really great.
Because nutrition is really important.
Nope.
What's that?
What did you say?
We make homemade granola.
This homemade granola.
The most popular features of our program is the granola. And if any client has, we need to get closer. If any client has children, the children get fed as well. And they get breakfast. So we get a lot of compliments on this. The granola.
Amazing.
Did you see Will and Grace last Thursday, Kipton?
No, I missed it.
There's a whole scoop on I Love Lucy, and they did different iconic scenes.
Oh, and you're kidding me.
One of the scenes was when she did the conveyor belt with the chocolates.
I remember.
This
that was
is our version of that.
I'll have to watch that episode.
And we don't have chocolates.
Yeah, show us one of the meals.
Yeah. And so these are like links of these trays. And this is turkey roni, which is one of my favorite dishes. And it's got beautiful carrot and rice. And look, it's suitable for diabetic, low lactose, low fat, no antisodium, renal, which is kidney failure, soft diet, no lactose, no nut, no pork, no fish. So you see the lengths we go through to make sure that the dietary needs of our clients.
Well, yeah, because of the illnesses of the people that
cleaning everything.
Can you repeat that?
Yeah, repeat the Oh, sorry. I was just saying, because of the different illnesses that people are going through, you customize the meals per yeah. person. And I think that's incredible.
Take over the camera and flip it. So I can hear you better.
Yeah, I was just saying, it's really beautiful how you customize the meals for each person, just like you were describing, because each individual has different health needs. Some are, you know, diabetics, or some are in unique situations where they need special proteins or
there's different dietary requirements for each person. And look at this. We have a shelf filled with, let me flip this camera, of all these spices. Because we take the salt out, we add this other stuff.
Wow.
Garlic.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing that the amount of thought and love that goes into every single meal for the clients is really inspiring. What are you making there?
Let's see. What is this breaded chicken? What's the flavor? What is this? Looking at the menu to find out.
This it's all is good. A
delicious breaded chicken. These are huge pieces of chicken.
They are.
Yeah, and look at this. Like, we do everything in bulk. And so you see just the mass quantity.
Well, and you look also.
We're all about social distancing. These lines tell you where you can stand. The proper distance from each other.
Wow, Richard. It's incredible how you've been able to just organize everything to keep the operations going during this time.
Well, it's so important that these people keep the meals coming. You know, they can't shop. They can't go to the grocery stores like you can. Look at that.
That's right.
And so we are their shopper, we're their chef, we're their delivery person. Here's Chef Rudy, hard at work.
Hi, Rudy.
Hi, Rudy. Say hi to Kipton.
Hi. Thank you for your work. It's beautiful what you're doing.
It's beautiful what you're doing. What is this? These are for clients with congestive heart failure. So it's kind of a different thing with low salt. Because people with congestive heart failure can only have 2 grams of salt a day. And just so you know, stalk of celery has 32 milligrams of salt. So here are turkey patties that we are putting in our big meal oven that they can be cooked. Yeah, tell everyone on Instagram.
Okay.
10 minutes,
take it. Amazing. It was hard to hear him. Richard, what was he saying?
So he said that these can be cooked in 10 minutes.
Okay.
And you could cook 500 at a time. And here they are.
So the other thing that people should know is that you're making these meals fresh every day, but you're also freezing them. You have a huge freezer where you're storing the meals to serve at a later time, right? So
yeah, and when we freeze them, we flash freeze them. It packs all the flavors and trends with no preservatives whatsoever.
Amazing.
So the meals look like this.
They look great.
Wow, that's incredible.
They're colorful because when you're sick, you need something colorful. And then they go into this flash freezer. You see that?
First time.
Coming
yeah.
in?
Yep.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Anything else for the time and place. Well, thank you so much, Richard, for giving us a tour. For every for people that have just joined, there's an art auction that that we announced earlier in the call. I'm going to post this conversation to my my story. You guys can watch it at later time. And all the 100% of the proceeds of the sale of the art will go towards Project Angel Food here in Los Angeles and the beautiful work that they're doing to serve people in need. Richard, do you have anything else to say before we end?
Kipton, I appreciate you showcasing Project Angel Food through art and also through philanthropy and through the good work. And it's just incredible. I think the sun is on the wrong place.
You look good. Well,
I will give you one little tidbit of information.
Tell us.
That thought that you would ask, but since you didn't,
tell us.
I'm going to give it to you. It is true that Prince Harry and Meghan have delivered meals for us.
Oh, incredible.
Over the last week, they delivered to 20 different clients. In West Hollywood, Burbank, Glendale.
Oh, and Richard.
They are as amazing as you would think they are.
Oh, that's beautiful. Thank you for letting us know, for sharing that information. That's beautiful. Well, it's inspiring that there's so much love for Project Angel Food. We want to do all we can to raise the money for you to serve more meals. And so, you know, let me know what else we can do. Maybe we go on another live call in a week or so.
Let's
and
do it.
Do this again. So.
Okay.
All right. Bye for now. Stay safe. Thank you, everybody, for joining.
Bye-bye.
Bye.